Welcome everyone, this is Xencord from Alpha Project Cluster. This video will talk about building an unreadable shadow cave in Aberrations. Like you can see, this dead wall is pretty much overpowered. And the fact that it starts from the waters, the start of the cave is from underwaters, make it even more overpowered. So now this is the locations of the shadow cave. Okay, I already pre-made the pillars and some stuff because we don't want this video to end up into a pillar spamming video. So now you can see the entrance of the cave. So we don't want to place too much turrets because these turrets will be easy blowable, and we don't want to fill them too much. And like you can see, these turrets, I've used them to know the distances we need to put the wall, because where I am, it's where the turret shoot. Yeah, the max limit, right here. So it don't shoot at the bottom, but the sum of the turrets that is most close will do shoots at the bottom of the water lake. So now, we just place a minimum turrets with minimum bullets, like maybe 1 or 2k heavy and 500 shard maybe. You can place more if you're confident enough, but good raiders will blow the hatch frames with tech rifles, or if they manage to body block and get close to blow it with C4s, it's also that's enough. No need more turrets. It will just slow them down a little bit before to actually get to the walls. And well, these fence support is not necessary. This fence support is just available on the Structure Plus, because the normal ones cannot be placed like that. It will just make kind of more annoying to reach the actual walls. But if you're not playing with Structure Plus on official servers, you better have nothing that plays something that will block the turrets. So now, let's place the walls. We want to set two foundations high, well, two walls high of between each ceiling, because we want to have the most velo possible on the walls. It is what make this location special and very powerful. It's the number of velo we can place on the walls. Okay. Well, we can just skip a little bit if you don't want to see all the ceiling getting placed. It's always good to have an hatch frames and on the top, because it will allow some turrets to get better angles on the riders. Okay, now for the turret positioning, I will prefer to place the turrets in front of the pillars. Yeah. Because the tech rifle cannot damage turrets, so it's kind of give an extra protection to pillars, and most the real reason is for the velos. The velos, it will allow to have more place for the velos between the pillars, like actually getting stuck in front of the pillars. They will feel much easier if they have such a low amount of space. So better use them for the turrets for these two reasons.
Thank you.
for the turrets left, there's always good to have some extra turrets in the grounds. We never know what's happened. Okay. So that's what the wall looked like without all the velos. Pretty much amazing, even what else. And that's it. So I hope this video will help you. Please leave a like and subscribe, and have a nice day.